Welcome to the training on .NET Framework by Nishant Infosys. In this session, we will discuss about hyperlinks and link buttons. Let us talk about hyperlinks. In ASP.NET Web Forms, the hyperlink control is used to create clickable links that navigate users to different pages or external URLs. This control provides a convenient way to integrate navigation and provide users with access to various resources or actions directly from your web application. The hyperlink control allows you to set properties such as navigate URL, which specifies the target URL, and text, which defines the link's display text. Additionally, it supports various attributes like target, which controls how the linked content is displayed, example in a new window or the same frame. By leveraging the hyperlink control, developers can enhance user experience through straightforward navigation options and seamless integration within their web pages. In this example, the hyperlink control is used to create a clickable link on the web page. The navigate URL property is set to https://www.google.com, which defines the URL to which users will be redirected when they click the link. The text property specifies the text displayed for the link, visit google.com. The target is equal to _blank attribute ensures that the link opens in a new browser tab or window, providing a better user experience by keeping the original page open. This control is useful for integrating external resources or navigating within your application while maintaining a seamless user interface. This is the output of the previous example. Let us discuss the unique features of hyperlinks in ASP.NET Framework. Dynamic URL binding, the USP. Hyperlink control allows for dynamic URL binding, meaning you can set the navigate URL property programmatically or through data binding. This enables you to generate URLs based on runtime data, making it flexible for scenarios where URLs need to be determined dynamically based on user input or other conditions. Target attribute, the USP. Hyperlink control includes the target attribute, which specifies where the linked document should be opened. Options like _blank, to open in a new window or tab, _self, default, to open in the same frame, _parent, and _top allow you to control the navigation experience, providing more control over how users interact with the linked content. Now, let us see how we can dynamically change the navigation URL of a hyperlink from the code behind page. Let us consider the previous example of hyperlink with the ID hyperlink1. Its navigation URL is set to google.com and the text reads visit google.com. We can programmatically change the navigation URL as well as the text as shown in the example. Hyperlink1.navigateURL is equal to www.amazon.in, which means that the navigation URL has been changed to Amazon and not Google. Hyperlink1.text is equal to go to Amazon, means that the hyperlink text is changed to go to Amazon. This is the output of the previous snippet. Now, let us discuss about link buttons. In ASP.NET Web Forms, the link button control is used to create clickable links that function like buttons, allowing you to trigger server-side events while visually resembling hyperlinks. Unlike the hyperlink control, which only navigates to a URL, the link button can handle user interactions directly on the server, making it suitable for executing server-side logic, such as form submissions or data processing, when clicked. It can be styled using CSS to look like a traditional link, but it retains the ability to handle events like a regular button. This control is ideal for scenarios where you need the appearance of a hyperlink combined with the functionality of a button, providing a seamless user experience within your web application. Let us take a look at an example of a link button. In the provided asks page code, the link button control is used to create a clickable link that looks like a hyperlink but functions like a button. The text property sets the display text to click me, and the onClick event is linked to the link button 1_click event handler in the code behind find. This setup allows the link button to trigger server-side logic when clicked, providing functionality beyond simple navigation by enabling interaction with server-side code while maintaining the appearance of a hyperlink. This is the output of the previous example. Now, let us see how a link button works. In the code behind file, the link button 1_click method is defined to handle the click event of the link button control. When the link button is clicked, this method is executed, allowing you to perform server-side operations. In this example, the method uses response.write link button clicked to output a message directly to the web page, indicating that the link button was clicked. This demonstrates how you can use the link button control to run server-side code and respond to user interactions, providing a way to execute logic and update the page dynamically based on user actions. This is the output when we click the link button. Now, let us carry on with the practice problem. Create a hyperlink that initially redirects to Microsoft website and change the navigation URL to redirect to Google home page. This needs to be done dynamically from the code behind page. Also, create a link button that displays, "Congratulations, the button is clicked successfully," on our page. We hope that this session has been insightful. In the next sessions, we will discuss on more elements of ASP.NET framework. Thank you.